Every parent just wants to see their child grow up healthily and happily. But when the unthinkable happens, it is difficult to understand what the future holds. David Smith suffers from a huge tumor located inside his head. The tumor is mostly inaccessible using commonly performed surgeries. After three different surgeries where his face was cut wide open, resulting in slight scarring and an unsuccessful course of radiotherapy, he was sent home and told he only had a few months to live. That was nearly 13 years ago.
Dit is nie lekker om sulke nuus te kry dat jou kind gaan sterf of dat jou kind dit gaan maak. Ek huil, ek gaan sit daar by die strand met 'n visstok en dan huil ek net meer uit, dan kom ek huis toe. En so gemaklik soos hy sit, hy is altyd die een wat vir my sê, "Mami, hoekom lyk mami so af?" Raak rustig.
The traditional surgery, even for benign tumors involving the sinuses encroaching on the brain, is open surgery, whereby the face is essentially cut into. This can be disfiguring and often leads to a lengthy hospital admission.
Op daai stadium, as David se gesig net so geswel en sy oë het half uitgehang, dit was baie moeilik. Moeilik om te vat, ek wou dit eintlik vat die en. Ek het vir dokter Lubbe gesê, hulle moet net doen wat hulle moet doen, ons plaas om in 'n hoër.
An innovative operation being performed by the Department of Ear, Nose and Throat Surgery with the Department of Neurosurgery at Grote Skier Hospital enabled access to this tumor and allowed David to surpass all expectations. Professor Patrick Semple and Dr. Darlene Lubbe began performing these surgeries nearly 10 years ago.
I'm going to just explain to you what we're going to do tomorrow. It's exactly the same thing that we've been doing all along. It's not very different to what it was 3 years ago, but there's some big cysts. And now the technology we have, and we know that it's been quite safe the last 12 years, just going back and back every time. The piece of tumor that's left is basically sitting at the top in the middle of your head. So what we're going to do tomorrow, so we come in with our little camera. We'll use both nostrils, and myself and Professor Semple will be operating together. So the camera will basically go up into the nose, but will actually come through this area here.
Surgery is essentially endoscopic surgery, which means there's no incisions generally made. And we work through the cavities within the face, which are the sinuses and the nose.
We now go through the nostrils and we go 15, 16 centimeters beyond the entry to the nose. You really need a special instrumentation, but also special GPS systems to guide you where you're going. Because one slip up, if you're praying an important artery or nerve, patients are essentially blind or can die on the table. So you have to have your accuracy up to a millimeter or even less than that.
Unfortunately, the equipment is expensive and the departments have to rely on generous donations from various sponsors in order to secure all the necessary equipment to perform these surgeries.
We met Dr. Lubbe at an ENT congress and we listened to one of her talks and presentations, and it seemed that she was doing slightly different surgery. She was bridging the gap between neurosurgery and ENT surgery as far as minimally invasive techniques went. And we were very, very interested, and we started a discussion with her to find out more about what she was doing. And we realized that then her surgery was slightly different from the mainstream surgery, and she needed different tools and different instruments.
With surgical innovations helping to supply some of the equipment necessary for the surgery method, Dr. Lubbe and Professor Semple have been able to perform many successful non-invasive surgical operations. Dr. Lubbe and Professor Semple want to enable even more people to benefit from this fantastic surgical opportunity. To do this, they require a brand new operating theatre that is fitted with the latest equipment. For this dream to become a reality, funding is needed in order to get the equipment necessary for this operating theatre.
So we're looking at about 6-7 million rand to build a theatre. For this we need the best high definition camera systems, which cost about 2 million rand. We need the GPS system, which is from 1.5 to 3.5 million rand. And then with that, all the drill systems and special instrumentation.
It's nice to see people like Dr. Lubbe and others that are still heavily involved in the state service, providing state-of-the-art care to people who can't ordinarily afford private healthcare, but also being involved in training and teaching young doctors.
We get surgeons from all over South Africa, sometimes from other African countries, that then come and learn how to use that instrumentation. Our aim is to have people across all of sub-Saharan Africa essentially to benefit.
Toe ons hier kom in 2002 was het, ons was onseker, maar met die hulp van die verpleegsters en spesiaal Dr. Libbe wat 'n pad saam met ons gestap het. Sy's regtig 'n unieke mens om saam mee te werk en ek dink ons het later by God geskeel soos 'n familie geword. Hulle doen regtig 'n baie goeie diens. Ek sal altyd daar buitekant uitdra dat God geskeel is een van die beste hospitale.
My confidence is baie meer, of ek is meer gemakkeliker met die nuwe operasie.
I met David when he was 12 years old and he's now 13 years post that initial debulking surgery. He's completely fine now, he doesn't have any further seizures.
En vir David wil ek baie dankie sê. David is eintlik my sterk motivering.